This weekend is the 6th wedding anniversary of you two. At the time, there were a great many people who...
What do you mean, legal?
Yeah. Isn't it?
Yeah. Oh.
Listen, but, well, if you are so devoted to each other, as I think you are, what about all these rows? You can't pick up a movie magazine or anything about Liz and Dick battling?
No, I must say we enjoy fighting. I think that fighting with somebody you love and are really sure of, and if you're really sure of yourself in your love, I think having a fight, an out-and-out, outrageous, ridiculous fight, is one of the greatest exercises in marital togetherness. I think
especially
it's
super. Especially if you have no really weak points.
Oh, I see.
You see, you do not attack the weak points. They're perfectly obvious in Elizabeth and myself. So when I insult Elizabeth, which I frequently do, I do not attack that soft spot in the underbelly. And when she attacks me, double chins.
You bloody well have.
Yeah, she's got a slightly fat belly. I never
use those things. Well, I've got his pock marks, you know.
Well, we can attack those things, but they're superficial.
No, the ethics and
you're more vulnerable, I'm sure, on other things than that.
Well, yes, I am, yeah. We've always had, of course, the enormous problem, Elizabeth and myself, of my being essentially a stage actor and Elizabeth a film actress. And so we frequently have lovely quarrels about that, where Elizabeth describes stage actors as being full of rubbish, and I reply
just
that...
just more pontifical.
Has Richard, in the years you've been together, Elizabeth, taught you anything about reading lines?
Well, not lines, but certainly poetry.
Yes.
The thing he taught me was, forget the metronome. Forget what you were taught in school. Just think of the meaning of the poem.
Is that the way you do a script, a film script, a prose script?
Well, I've only... all the scripts I've done have been prose.
Yeah.
I've only done one in verse, and that was Taming of the Shrew. And I was absolutely terrified because I was in this company of old Shakespearean actors. Not necessarily old, but, you know, they've been there for a long time. And these camp characters, you know, that you just can't turn your back on because they're, you know, picking their nose, scratching their bottoms. I mean, they'll do anything. And here was I, you know, sort of a Hollywood schmuck trying to sort of keep up with them. And I said, Richard, what am I going to do?
And the old
said,
man give you any help?
Yeah. He said, get out of the nest, baby. You do it on your own. And I said, thanks a bloody bunch.
He's a professional Welshman. Does that get on your nerves sometimes?
Well, I'm a professional Jew, so, you know, it's a good contest.
No, I once remember telling...
I mean, after all, we do have Jesus Christ, don't we? And he doesn't. He's claimed it. But he hasn't convinced me yet.
Jesus Christ was unquestionably Welsh.
No!
You two are parents and very devoted ones, as far as I've watched you with your children. What do you think about the problem of this modern world and all the changes that it's bringing to children? Something wrong with the younger generation, Elizabeth?
Oh, Godler, I don't know. I think my kids are on a right track. My oldest son, 17, has the hair that is infradig to the oldsters, the clothes that are poor, squares. He's been hippie hunted down. He's not, well, I don't know what the word hippie means. I really don't understand that word. He has long hair. I like hair. He looks beautiful.
But do you mean people insult him, or?
Oh, they insult him. They say, hey, girly, and, you know, tag a tug on a scarf
that
or something.
Not at all girly.
One doesn't have
he's
to
the
worry
very
about
opposite.
That.
As a matter of fact, he might exceed my particular capacity in that sense.
I am so fortunate that he is not one of these kids that goes out and mugs people. I'm so lucky that he doesn't find it necessary to get vicarious kicks out of beating old ladies up or doing scenes like, they have been here lately.
So you think the kids are getting a bum rap?
I do. I really do. Just because they have long hair and they wear the same kind of clothes that we pay a hell of a lot of money for from Vogue and Bazaar, I think these kids are getting a bum rap.
Well, obviously, I've talked to him because he's, in a sense, my son now, you know, because he's been with me for 10, 12 years, and he's only 17 now. And I say, why, if you wear such outrageous clothes and your hair chopped to a certain length, which you know is going to accord you embarrassment, like, for instance, just coming to see his mother and myself at the, shall we say, the Dorchester Hotel, and they won't let him in, you know, until...
Until they find out who he is.
Until they find out that he's our son.
That really just makes me so angry.
But his answer...
Because he is our son, they'll let him in.
But,
if he were Mrs. Jones's son, they wouldn't let him in. It's like, it's like the kind of thing in New York that happened to me a few years ago. I wanted to buy a co-op apartment. And as you know, I'm a convert to Judaism.
God help us all.
And there's nothing worse than a convert.
But they wouldn't let you in.
Nothing worse than a
couldn't get
converted...
an apartment in New York.
No, but they said, we'll make an exception for you because you're Elizabeth Taylor. We'll let you in. And I said, you can take your building and you know where to put it.
Well, what do you tell them about things like pot, which all these kids experiment with?
How can I say to my son or my children, you can't go out and smoke pot? I have said it, by the way. When we go out and have martinis, and we know that that is killing our livers, and when we are smoking cigarettes, and we know that we might die of cancer, and you're the adult, you're the grown-up, you're supposed to know. So when you ask that question, what do you say?
Elizabeth, you aren't advocating pot for young people, are you?
No, I'm not. Oh, my God, no, I'm not. I'm not advocating cigarettes. I'm not advocating booze. The one thing that really does terrify me for young people is LSD, the hard drugs. And that really scares me because I've known children of friends of mine that have taken LSD and they've blown their minds. So I oppose that so totally and thoroughly. And I'm not advocating pot.
But in a sense, both of you identify with young people. Those symbols you're wearing around your neck, isn't that a peace or a love symbol?
It seems to work because we haven't quarreled for at least 48 hours.
Stick around.
You give each other a lot of presents. You're always giving Elizabeth presents, like that bit of ice cube you have on your finger there, dear.
What's to keep me cool?
That's a beauty. That's the big one, isn't it?
It's not small, is it?
No.
Richard, you're nominated for an Oscar this year. How many nominations have you had?
This is the sixth.
Do you think that that this role in Anne of a Thousand Days is the best one he's done in films and the one most deserving of an Oscar?
No.
Which do you think was his best one?
I think Virginia Woolf, because it was so opposite to his personality.
Wow. You think he dominates you?
You must be joking.
In your real life?
Charles, you've got to be kidding.
Richard?
He sure does.
Do you think that you dominate
now?
Elizabeth?
I think that, no, I don't. I would say offhand that when the bludgeon is out, which Elizabeth employs with remarkable efficacy, that I'm afraid I have to withdraw. I think that if there is a hen peck around the place, it's me.
Oh, Mamma Mia.
Getting back to the Oscars, do you think that it usually happens that the best performer or the best of whatever category is the one who gets it?
I won it the first time for a film called Butterfield 8, and I went on the record for a long time saying that I thought the film stunk, and I still do. I don't think I was particularly good in it, but I'd had pneumonia and had my throat cut open, tracheotomy, and I won that year, and I had some really hot competition, some really superb actresses, and I won that year.
Sympathy.
I think it was sympathy.
Why is it that people really want an Oscar? What does it do for an actor?
Well, I don't know, the mystique, I think, of the Oscar is very strange. Nobody quite knows what it is. It's part sentiment, it's part affection, it's part of the business, of course, which was, in a sense, created here, right here in Hollywood.
And it's given to you, sorry for interrupting, it's given to you, awarded to you by your peers.
I won't ask you whether you think you're going to win, because that would be unfair.
Oh, he's already, I can tell you.
What?
He's, as far as he's concerned, he's already lost. I mean, if anybody could make a loser speech, he's already made it. I mean, mentally, Richard doesn't think he's going to get it.
Do you think he should?
I sure do.
And he's only 17 now. And I say, what? Why, if you wear such outrageous clothes and your hair chopped to a certain length, which you know is going to accord you embarrassment, like, for instance, just coming to see his mother and myself at the, shall we say, the Dorchester Hotel, and they won't let him in, you know, until...
Until they find out who he is.
Until they
and
find
that
out that
really
he's our
just
son.
Makes me so angry.
But his
because
answer...
Because he is our son, they'll let him in.
But
if he were Mrs. Jones's son, they wouldn't let him in. It's like, it's like the kind of thing in New York that happened to me a few years ago. I wanted to buy a co-op apartment. And as you know, I'm a convert to Judaism.
God help us all.
And they, there's nothing worse than a convert.
But they wouldn't let
they
you
say, nothing the, worth, the, worse
Elizabeth
than
couldn't
a
get
converted.
An apartment yeah. in New York.
No, but they said, we'll make an exception for you because you're Elizabeth Taylor. We'll let you in. And I said, you can take your building and you know where to put it.
Well, what are you telling about things like pot, which all these kids experiment with?
How can I say to my son or my children, you can't go out and smoke pot? I have said it, by the way. When we go out and have martinis, and we know that that is killing our livers, and when we are smoking cigarettes and we know that we might die of cancer.
The years you've been together, Elizabeth, taught you anything about reading lines?
Well, not lines, but certainly poetry.
Yes.
The thing he taught me was forget the metronome. Forget what you were taught in school. Just think of the meaning of the poem.
Is that the way you do a script, a
film script, prose script?
Well, I've only... All the scripts I've done have been prose. Yeah. I've only done one in verse, and that was Taming of the Shrew. And I was absolutely terrified because I was in this company of old Shakespearean actors. Not necessarily old, but, you know, they've been there for a long time. And these camp characters, you know, that you just can't turn your back on because they're, you know, picking their nose, scratching their bottoms. I mean, they'll do anything. And here was I, you know, sort of a Hollywood schmuck trying to sort of keep up with them. And I said, Richard, what am I going to do?
And the old man give you any help?
Yeah. He said, get out of the nest, baby. You do it on your own. And I said, thanks a bloody bunch.
He's a professional Welshman. Does that get on your nerves sometimes?
Well, I'm a professional Jew, so, you know, it's a good contest.
No, I once remember telling...
I mean, after all, we do have Jesus Christ, don't we? And he doesn't. He's claimed it. But he hasn't convinced me yet.
Jesus Christ was unquestionably Welsh.
But no! Anyway...
You two are parents... And very devoted ones, as far as I watched you with your children. What do you think about the problem of this modern world? And
you're the adult. You're the grown-up. You're supposed to know. Mm. So when you ask that question, what do you say?
Elizabeth, you aren't advocating pot for young people, are you?
No, I'm not. Oh, my God, no, I'm not. I'm not advocating cigarettes. I'm not advocating booze. The one thing that really does terrify me for young people is LSD, the hard drugs. And that really scares me because I've known children of friends of mine that have taken LSD and they've blown their minds. So I oppose that so totally and thoroughly. And I'm not advocating pot.
But in a sense, both of you identify with young people. Those symbols you're wearing around your neck, isn't that a peace or a love symbol?
It seems to work because we haven't quarreled for at least 48 hours.
Stick around.
You give each other a lot of presents. You're always giving Elizabeth presents like that... bit of ice cube you have on your finger there, dear.
What's to keep me cool?
That's a beauty. That's the big one, isn't it?
It's not small, is it?
No.
Richard, you're nominated for an Oscar this year. How many nominations have you had?
This is the sixth.
Do you think that that this role in Anne of a Thousand Days is the best one he's done in films and the one most deserving of an Oscar?
No.
Which do you think was his best one?
I think Virginia Woolf, because it was so opposite to his personality.
Wow. Do you think he dominates you?
You must be joking.
In your real life?
Charles, you've got to be kidding.
All the changes that it's bringing to children. Something wrong with the younger generation, Elizabeth?
Oh, Godler, I don't know. But I think my kids are on a right track. My oldest son, 17, has the hair that is infradict to the oldsters, the clothes that are poor, squares. He's been hippie hunted down. He's not, well, I don't know what the word hippie means. I really don't understand that word. He has long hair. I like hair. He looks beautiful.
But do you mean people insult him or?
They insult him. They say, "Hey, girly," and you know, tag a tug on a scarf
that he's,
or something.
Not at all girly.
One doesn't have
he's
to
the
worry
very
about
opposite.
That.
As a matter of fact, he might exceed my particular capacity in that sense.
I am so fortunate that he is not one of these kids that goes out and mugs people. I'm so lucky that he doesn't find it necessary to get vicarious kicks out of beating old ladies up or doing scenes like, they have been here lately.
So you think the kids are getting a bum rap?
I do. I really do. Just because they have long hair and they wear the same kind of clothes that we pay a hell of a lot of money for from Vogue and Bazaar, I think these kids are getting a bum rap.
Well, obviously, I've talked to him because he's, in a sense, my son now, because he's been with me for 10, 12 years.
This weekend is the 6th wedding anniversary of you two. At the time, there were a great many people who...
What do you mean, legal?
Yeah. Isn't it?
Yeah. Oh.
Listen, if you are so devoted to each other, as I think you are, what about all these rows? You can't pick up a movie magazine or anything about Liz and Dick battling?
No, I must say we enjoy fighting. I think that fighting with somebody you love and are really sure of, and if you're really sure of yourself in your love, I think having a fight, an out-and-out outrageous, ridiculous fight, is one of the greatest exercises in marital togetherness. I think
especially
it's
especially if you have no really weak points.
Oh, I see.
You see, you do not attack the weak points. They're perfectly obvious in Elizabeth and myself. So when I insult Elizabeth, which I frequently do, I do not attack that soft spot in the underbelly.
My
and when she
chin.
Attacks me, double chins.
You bloody you well know. Have.
Yeah, she's got a slightly fat belly. I never
well,
use
those
things.
Well, I've got his pockmarks,
Well, we can attack those
ethics.
Things, but they're superficial.
No, the ethics and
You're more vulnerable, I'm sure, on other things than that.
Yes, I am, yeah. We've always had, of course, the enormous problem, Elizabeth and myself, of my being essentially a stage actor and Elizabeth a film actress. And so we frequently have lovely quarrels about that, where Elizabeth describes stage actors as being full of rubbish, and I reply
just
that...
just more pontifical.
Has Richard in the...